Hello, great Indians. Today we are going to study the most important chapter, that is real number, that is included in the class 10th. So this is the lecture first of the class 10th, chapter number 1, that is real numbers. So what are real numbers? Before going to study the real numbers, let's learn what are the numbers we have already studied in the lower classes. How many numbers are there? First of all, we will start with the natural numbers. What are natural numbers? Natural numbers are those numbers which starts with 1, 2, 3 and so on. Then whole numbers. Whole numbers are those numbers, those number which starts with the 0. It means that a 0 and the natural number, this both combination will give you a whole number. Next, we'll talk about the integers. What are integers? Integers are those numbers which contains the positive number, negative numbers and the 0 also. It means all the positive numbers, 0 number and the negative numbers, all this set includes the integers. Next, let's talk about the rational numbers. What are rational numbers? Rational numbers are those numbers which can be converted into the fractions. Means any number if can be converted into the fraction, these numbers are called as the rational numbers. Means p by q, p is nothing but the numerator, q is called as the denominator. If any number can be written in the p by q form, then it can be called as a rational numbers. Next, let's talk about the irrational number. If any number which cannot be converted into the fraction, which cannot be written in the p by q form, then that numbers are called as the irrational numbers. And both the combinations of the rational and the irrational gives you the real numbers. So what are real numbers? Real numbers are those numbers which are the combinations of the rational and irrational number. As we have already studied in the class 9, that any number, any real number can be represented on the number line, but we will not discuss here. So here you can see this is the classification of the real numbers. Real numbers are classified into two numbers, rational numbers and the irrational number, as I have already explained you that the real numbers are classified into two numbers, that is the rational numbers and the irrational numbers. We will start with the lower numbers. We have studied the natural numbers which starts with 1, 2, 3 and so on. Next, we come to the whole numbers. Whole numbers are those numbers which starts with the 0. It means that 0 and the all natural numbers, these all sets consist of the whole numbers. It means that the whole numbers, it starts from the 0 and so on. Next, we come to the integers. Integers are those number which contains the positive number, negative number and the 0 also. It means all this set are called the integers. It means that integers can be defined as all the positive numbers, negative number and 0 also. Remember, this 0 is also an integer. Next, we come to the rational numbers. Rational numbers are those numbers which can be converted into the fractions. If any number can be written in the fraction, that is p by q form, numerator and denominator, then those numbers are called as a rational number. So all natural numbers are whole numbers, all whole numbers are integers, and all integers are the rational numbers. But you can't come to the from rational numbers to the natural numbers. You can come from natural numbers to the rational numbers. Means all natural numbers are whole numbers, all whole numbers are integers, all integers are rational numbers. Remember, 0 is also a rational number. Okay, and next we talk about the irrational numbers. Irrational numbers are those numbers which cannot be written into the fractions. Okay, so this combination of the rational and the irrational are called as a real numbers. This is the classification chart. All natural numbers are whole numbers. Natural numbers starts with 1, 2, 3 and so on. Next, this is whole numbers. Whole numbers, it starts from the 0, 1, 2 and so on. Next, we come to the integers. Integers are those numbers which consist of positive, negative and 0 also. Next is the rational numbers. If any number can be written in the p by q form, then those numbers are called as a rational number. You can see this. All natural numbers are whole numbers. All whole numbers are integers. All integers are rational numbers. Okay. And next we come to the irrational numbers. Irrational numbers are those numbers which cannot be written into the fraction. The combination of the rational and the irrational gives you the real number. So real numbers are those numbers which consist of the rational numbers and the irrational numbers also. So this is the first topic of our syllabus, that is Euclid's division lemma. Euclid was nothing but the Greek mathematician. He was also known as the father of the geometry. Okay, so he has proposed one division theorem, that is division lemma. Lemma is nothing but the statement which can be proved for proving the another statement. So Euclid division lemma states that if for a given, for any two positive integers a and b, you can write this integers as a equals to bq plus r. Means if you divide any number by a, though it gives you this results, a equals to bq plus r, where a is a dividend, b is a divisor, q is a quotient and r is a remainder. You have already learned in your lower classes that the division equals to dividend equals to divisor multiplied by quotient plus remainder. This is nothing but the same format, a equals to bq plus r, where a is dividend, b is divisor, q is quotient and r is a remainder. So this is the example of the Euclid division lemma. You have to divide 217 by a 5, means 217 is a dividend, 5 is a divisor. if you want to divide 217 by 5, okay, so your question is 43, 5, 5 4s are 20, 1 minus 7 minus 0 7, 1 minus 0 1, 1 minus 0 1, 17, again 5 3s are 15, 17 minus 5, 15 is 2, so remainder is 2. So if you divide the 217 by 5, you get the question 43 and the remainder 2. So you can write 217, that is dividend equals to divisor into question plus remainder. Okay, dividend is 217, divisor is 5, quotient is 43 plus remainder is 2. So dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So if any integer is divided by another integer, you can write that dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Notice one important point, that the remainder is always less than divisor. What is the remainder here? 2. What is the divisor here? 5. So 2 is less than 5. So in all the cases, remainder is always less than the divisor. So these are some more examples of the Euclid division lemma. If you want to divide 23 by 5, so how 23 can be written? It means a is dividend is 23, divisor is 5. So if you divide 23 by 5, so according to the Euclid division lemma, dividend, that is 23, equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. If you divide 23 by 5, you get the quotient 4 and then you get the remainder 3. So 23 equals to 5 into 4 plus 3. 5 4 is 20, 20 plus 3, 23. And the remainder is 3. Remainder is less than 5, as we have already studied that the remainder should be always less than a divisor. What is the divisor here? 5. So remainder is less than 5. So this is how you can write 23 if you divide 23 by the 5. This is the second question, second example. If you want to divide 35 by 7, so dividend is 35, divisor is 7. So by Euclid division lemma, 35 can be written as 35 equals to 7 into 5 plus 0. Because if you divide 35 by the 7, you get the remainder 0. So 35 can be written as 35 equals to 7 into 5 plus 0. So remainder is less than 7. Remainder is greater than 0 but less than 7. This is how if any integers are divided by the other integers, you can write by the Euclid division lemma that dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Next topic is Euclid's division algorithm. Euclid's division algorithm is a technique used to find the HCF of two positive integers. Means this algorithm is used to find the HCF of any two positive integers. You have already learned how you find the HCF. By our manual method, how you find the HCF? If two numbers are there, 135 and the 225. You have to find the HCF of 135 and the 225. Okay. So 135, what are the factors of 135? 345s are, 315s are, 35s are, and 51s are. So what are the factors of 135? 3, how many 3s are there? 1, 2, 3. 3 3s are there. Means 3 power 3 into 5. And what are the factors of 225? 225 can be written as 375s are, 325s are, 55s are, 51s are. So what are the how many 3s are there? 2 3s are there and 2 5s are there. Means 3 power 2 into 5 power 2. So if you find the HCF, you have to take the minimum power. What is the minimum power here? 3 power 3 and 3 power 2. So 3 power 2 is the minimum power. In 5, 5 power 1 and 5 power 2, what is the minimum power? 5 power 1. So 5 power 1 is the minimum power. So 3 square 9, 9 5 is 45. So what is the HCF of this 135 and 225? 45 is the HCF. We have already learned in the class 8 and 9th class. Okay. So but now we have to find the HCF using this Euclid's division algorithm. Let's see how you can find the HCF. So see, using the Euclid's division lemma, you have to find the HCF of 135 and 225. So out of these two numbers, take the bigger number 225 as a dividend and the lower number as a divisor. So A, dividend is 225 and the divisor is 135. So you have to divide the number, that is 225, by 135. So 135 ones are 135. Okay. 5 minus 5 0, 12 minus 3 9. So remainder is not 0, remainder is 90. So you have to continue the process until the remainder becomes a 0. So this is a step number 1. What is our Euclid division lemma? That A equals to B into Q plus R. So what is our A here? 225 is our A equals to. What is the divisor here? 135. So 135 into. What is our quotient? 1 plus remainder is 90. So this is our step number 1. Okay, you have to continue the process. Now this remainder will become the divisor. And this first step divisor will become the dividend. Okay, so 90, 1s are 90, 92s are 180, so 90 1s are is 90.
5 minus 0, 5. 13 minus 9, 45. So remainder is 45. So in this second step, again you have to write using the Euclid's. What is the dividend here? 135. So 135 equals to divisor is what? 90 into quotient is what? 1 plus remainder is 45. So again in the second step, again the remainder is not 0. So you have to continue the process. Remember, the divisor of the first step will become the dividend, and the remainder is always the divisor in the second step. 45 twos are 90, remainder is 0. So in the step number 3, what is our Euclid's division lemma? Dividend. What is the dividend? 90 equals to divisor is what? 45 into quotient is 2 plus remainder is 0. Now you have to stop here because now the remainder is 0. So what is the last divisor we have obtained? 45. So HCF of 135 and 225 is what? 45. Because in the third step you get the divisor is 45. So our HCF is what? 45. So in this way you have to follow this Euclid's division lemma and get the HCF. Okay student, so remember you have to continue the process until the remainder will become the 0. In the first step what we have done, you have to check whether which number is greater. So 225 is bigger number, 135 is the lower number. So you have to divide 225 by the 135, 135 by the 135, the remainder is 90. Now again you have to continue this process. Remember, the divisor of the first step will become the dividend and the remainder of the first step will become the divisor. So 91 again 95 minus 0, 5, 13 minus 9, 45. Now the remainder is again 45, remainder is not 0. So again you have to continue the process. The divisor will become the dividend, the remainder will become the divisor. 45 twos are 90, then now the remainder is 0. So last divisor where the remainder is 0 is called the HCF. So what is our HCF? 45. So HCF is 45.
So students, what we have learned today? We have learned today the first topic of our syllabus, that is Euclid's division algorithm. What is Euclid's division algorithm? It is a technique which is used to find the HCF of given two positive integers. So Euclid's division algorithm uses to find the HCF. Okay. So I hope you have understood this topic very well. So based on this topic, I have given you some homework. Okay. You have to find the HCF of these five numbers using the Euclid's division algorithm. You don't have to use the manual method. You have to use only the Euclid's division algorithm to find the HCF of these given numbers. Thank you.